Hello, a warm welcome to all of you. Myself, Dr. Subodh Kumar Jha, Associate Professor, Department of English, S.N. Sinha College, Jahanabad, Magad University, Bodh Gaya, Bihar. We take up today a very interesting topic. What is literature? Many of you, I am sure, can easily point out which is a work of literature and which is not. When we hear the word literature, we usually think of poems, novels, stories, etc. You will agree that literature is a very popular and widely used term. We use it in different contexts. When we buy a product, we ask for the literature of that product to know the details of that product. When we have to deal with a company, we ask for the literature of that company to know it very clearly. When we want to cook some dishes, we read the literature on it. This literature gives details of all the ingredients to be used and every step to be followed. If we want to understand the use of any appliance, we go through its literature so that we can use it effectively and efficiently. However, several of us won't accept it as pure literature. Why? This is strange. So the question arises, what is literature? Can we call all written documents literature? Here we need to understand that literature has both wide and narrow connotations. In a broad sense, any written document about anything is literature. But in a narrow or a strict sense, only some works, written or oral, can be called literature. Usually, when we hear the term literature, we think of poems, novels, stories, plays, etc. This is true in most of the cases. But this is not the case all the time. Even a book of history, such as Churchill's, or religious works such as the Bible and the Ramayana are literature. If we look at the purpose of different works, we come across different varieties which baffle us and also make us think what makes a work a literary work. Language, communication, expression, cognitive value, aesthetic value, moral value, or what else? Let's consider them one by one. Language is the tool of literature, be it oral or written. But language is used for various communications. So only the use of language is not enough for a work to be literature. Of course, literature uses language in a special way. The language of literature is different from normal spoken language, because it includes various kinds of literary and aesthetic or artistic devices, such as simile, metaphor, analogy, alliteration, assonance, consonance, rhyme, rhythm, parallelism, synonymy, etc. But literature is more than mere aesthetic devices. Then you may ask, is literature communication? Communication, no doubt, is a fundamental component. If there is no communication, there is no literature. But communication can be of different types. When one is interested in giving just an information, such as 2 + 2 = 4, we do not consider it as a literary expression. When we converse with our friends or relatives, usually it is no literature. But the moment a person tries to say something in a beautiful and charming manner, we have a feeling that he is engaged in a literary enterprise. My heart lifts up when I behold a rainbow in the sky. Just substitute some words or phrases, lips up, with jump, or behold with see, or change the word order and you will see, or you will mark the change in impact. Similar is the case with my love is like a red, red rose that newly sprung in June. Omit the repetition of red and mark the change. This holds good to several other expressions, the proverbs. They are also literature. For example, when we say an empty vessel sounds much, or morning shows the day, or in any language, this is true. It is not always that a writer can say something in a memorable manner, but when he does succeed, he has produced literature, however small or however little its value may be. This manner brings us to the question, is literature expression? This question reminds me of Matthew Arnold, who said in his Essays in Criticism that literature is the record of the best that is known and thought in the world. It is also true that not many people do deliberately try to produce literature, but the records of their thoughts and experiences describing certain situations, real or imaginary, contain in them immense literary value. Such were the writings of Winston Churchill, whose writings on the Second World War brought him the highest literary awards, the Nobel Prize for Literature. Rousseau's Confessions, or De Quincey's Confessions of an English Opium Eater, are regarded as literary works. In fact, a literary artist is more concerned with interpreting himself rather than in revealing himself to others. Literature, therefore, may be defined as an art by which expression is achieved in language. However, when we say that, we have just touched the tip of an iceberg. Literature is more than mere expression. It is the aesthetic value of the expression that makes us say that this work is literature and this is not. Why is it that a book of history by Churchill is termed literature, but the same cannot be said about other books of history? Or Nehru's Glimpses of World History is rated as a work of literature? The reason is, other books simply record the fact or at best include comments on the facts. But some books, such as Churchill's or Nehru's, do more than this. They do not remain informative with very definite denotation and connotations. They become emotive as well. They have a feeling content, and this helps them qualify for literature. We may say that in literature, the writers exploit the sources of language and the evocative powers of words for the expression of various kinds of experiences. Literature, therefore, may be described as a kind of imaginative writing because it is only through the faculty of imagination that a writer can scan all his experiences, sift them, and recreate some of them into a verbal artifact. In literature, cognitive value is also of supreme importance. A work of art, through the concrete particulars, reveals the universal. For example, by portraying the pangs of separation of the yaksha, Kalidasa portrays a universal feeling. Or, when Macbeth says, "Life is a tale told by an idiot, full of sounds and fury, signifying nothing," he is universalizing the emptiness or hollowness or nothingness of life. Macbeth's experience is no more a personal experience. It becomes universal in appeal because of a wonderful transmutation of sharp concreteness of individual's life into emotive and evocative universal appeal. to seize the universal and to reproduce it in simple and sensuous form is not to reflect a reality already familiar through sense perception. Rather, it is a rivalry of nature, a completion of her unfulfilled purposes, a correction of her failures. This is what Bucher observes in connection with Aristotle's concept of imitation. Literature thus illuminates life in different possible way. This act of illuminating life adds another value to it, which we may call moral value. Morality in literature is not necessarily what we mean by ethical. At bottom, it is criticism of life. It helps readers view life in different perspectives, in its totality. The greatness of literature is as much due to its aesthetic richness as to the philosophy enunciated in it. It is not possible to define what literature is. At best, we can say that in a broader sense, every subject has its own literature, which describes in detail as to what the subject is all about. This sort of literature may be called informative literature. We also have non-aesthetic or critical literature, in which a particular subject is clarified in a logical manner, and it often uses the cause and effect nature of things. For example, books of philosophy, science, and mathematics. In such a literature, the emphasis is on gathering information, remembering facts, and finding solutions for a problem. However, in its strictest or a specific sense, a work of literature is an aesthetic and cognitive discourse with moral values embedded in it, and the end is either delight or rasa or instruction and delight. It appeals both to our heart and mind. This may also be called true literature or creative literature. I hope now we can tell with more clarity what constitutes literature and which is a work of literature. Thank you all.